Sarah Shook. I'm from Eau Claire, Wisconsin. I'm double majoring in English and political science. I'm in my fourth year, going on my victory lap here, fifth year. And I'm currently the ranking student representative to the Board of Regents. I am the former Panhellenic president, which is one of the largest student groups on campus. And I'm involved on the board of directors for University Student Legal Services.
Hello, my name is Brandon Cofield. I'm out of Houston, Texas, a third-year student, double majoring in nutrition, as well as African-American studies. Currently, I sit on the exec board for the BSU. I'm the CFANS representative for MSA, as well as an active member of the CFANS student board. Also involved in University Spirit Squad. I'm a cheerleader now after playing football my freshman year, so trying to stay on the field somehow. And also, president of Manor Student Organization, so a small minority group out in St. Paul campus.
What qualifies Brandon and I to be MSA president and vice president is our vast experience with multiple different student groups. Brandon and I represent the largest student college and the smallest. We represent St. Paul campus and we represent the Minneapolis campus. We represent the Black Student Union and we represent the University Student Legal Service. So with our expanse of expertise in these different student groups, we're really positioned well to reach out and engage students in a meaningful way.
Yeah.
I can go, yeah. We are running because we think that we can make a difference. And it's time for leadership. We want to take back the student voice and give students a seat at the table in governing this university. So the way that we intend to do that is by reaching out and engaging the average student. And with our experience, we think that we are the best positioned to reach out to multiple student groups and engage them. And by engaging students, we get students who are more satisfied with their university experience, students who are more likely to graduate, and students who are more likely to graduate in 4 years.
And then, two or three things that MSA will confront in the next year will be increasing student engagement and retention on campus. Campus-wide, as well as in MSA forum and other MSA activities, student engagement is limited to actually right now less than 1% of student groups are involved of the 650 on campus at MSA forum. So the largest thing that we would like to look forward into doing is getting the students involved on campus, getting them their voice out there, making sure that everyone's represented, no voice is lost.
And this is a critical year for the university because in 2012, our stimulus funding runs out. And when that stimulus funding runs out, we will be facing a lot of different cuts on the university level. So one thing that we want to be sure is that students are engaged and they are active in the process of determining what is important to keep and what is important to cut. So students, we know more than anyone what is critical to the success of our student experience. And so this year, we need to really be engaged for those student budget cuts. We're more qualified as a team because of our experiences on campus. We've been involved in a wide range of student organizations, and that experience gives us a great position to reach out and engage more students. We've been involved, like I said before, in the largest student college and the smallest, and we've been involved in the Minneapolis and St. Paul campuses, and we've been involved in Gopher Athletics and Student Legal Service. So that wide range will make us more qualified because we have the experience reaching out. As a student rep to the Board of Regents, I organized student leader meetings so that students could be heard no matter their position on campus. And what we did with that information is we took it to the highest level of the university, at the Regents level. So, Brandon, do you have anything to add?
I guess another thing, I don't want to take anything away from anybody else's qualifications because every candidate is running because they believe in themselves. We feel like we're the most qualified because we're the most confident in our abilities to make change happen, the things that we feel are necessary for the upcoming school year that MSA needs to take on. So personally, I feel like Sarah and I are the best candidates because we believe in what we need to do. After talking to different students, a lot of people believe in us, so I feel like that's all we need.
I believe that this should be a nonpartisan position. And the reason that I believe that is because the university is constitutionally separate from the state. And at the state level, the state is responsible for giving us funding. But what we do at this university with that funding is up to the campus. And this is a nonpartisan organization. So while we may have political beliefs, those aren't going to shape our campaign or presidency. The MSA government right now is broken. And when we represent about 20 out of the 650 student groups in our student voice, we can't possibly be proactive. Right now, our student leadership is reactive. And we deserve leadership. It's time for leadership. So I encourage students to get out, and if you remember one thing from this entire interview, get out and vote. Because to not vote is to vote for the status quo. And we deserve accurate student representation, and we deserve leadership.
Excellent. And then my...
To raise the overall awareness of the student body, I think the biggest thing is getting on a personal level with as many individuals as possible, many different student groups, to hopefully it'll trickle down to as many different students, all in all. The raising awareness is just making sure that people are understanding the issues that are at hand. Because every day, every forum, MSA makes large decisions that are always front page news, but the majority of people that MSA speaks for either aren't aware of the issues or don't realize that MSA is speaking for them. So raising awareness, making sure that everyone knows what's going on and people are speaking for them, that they're speaking for them, like, with full consent, more or less.
It's time for leadership. We need you to get out there as a student and take part in your student government. Get out there and vote April 5th through the 7th and help make your student government accurate and representative of you.